Hi guys, my name is Naren Baghel and I welcome all of you, all the viewers of this video. And today's video I will be talking about differences between Server 2008, Server 2008 R2 and Server 2008, Server 2012, Server 2012 R2. What are the differences between all the version server version available as of now? And I prepared this video with the intention because, you know, if you are working in an organization, it is always better for you to have the knowledge of all the servers and what are the features, because whenever new thing comes, it comes with the lots of changes with new features, services. So we should have all the sufficient knowledge about all the versions available, so it becomes very easy for us to deal with the problems or resolve all the issues or fulfill the requirement of the business. So in this video, my intention is just to share few basic differences between Server 2008 and Server 2012, because if you are working in an organization and your organization is dealing with Server 2008 environment, and you need to upgrade your infrastructure, and so it is always better, it will be good for you to have the knowledge, or you can share with all the things of the new technology available with your management and go ahead for the to fulfill the requirement. So let's begin with the some features available with Server 2008 and Server 2012. So I'm going to talk about I'm talking about graphical user interface. What is the difference between Server 2008 and Server 2012? If we talk about Server 2008 graphical interface and Server 2012 graphical interface, so the big difference is, in case of Server 2008, you cannot switch your graphical interface user to CUI mode. CUI mode is core user interface. If you want to install CUI mode, then you will have to select, or you will have to install core server installation at the time of installation of the operating system or server in case of Server 2008. But if we compare this feature with Server 2012, you can switch from GUI mode to CUI mode, or vice versa. If you are working with core user interface and you want to switch to graphical user interface, it is possible with Server 2012, but it is not possible with Server 2008. So this one was one of the greatest feature added in Server 2012 and which is not available with Server 2008. Let's talk about the next one. What is the difference between Server 2008 and 2012? So server group can be created with this version. If we talk about Server 2012, we can create server group, and this remote management of the member server is also supported by this version, which is not supported by Server 2008. And let's go to next sentence. If we compare Server 2008 with Server 2012 and Server 2000 R, so we can see in Server 2012, 19 roles and 53 features were added additionally as compared to Server 2008. And if we talk about Server 2012 R2, so the number of role is greater as compared to Server 2012. The roles are 22 and features are 55 respectively, if we compare to Server 2008 and Server 2012 and Server 2000 R. And if we talk about physical RAM supported by Server 2008 and Server 2012, it is there is a big difference between both the server. If we talk about Server 2008, so the physical RAM can be extended up to 1 terabyte, but in Server 2012 it can be extended up to 4 terabytes. So it is one of the very, very strong and very, very important feature came with the Server 2012, because if you have a high RAM, your server will be performing very well, and This is very very additional feature added in this server 2012, because the performance of your server is depend on the physical memory available with the server. So let's talk about some other feature in next slide. What are the difference? If we talk about RAM per virtual machine, so if we compare between the RAM per virtual machine supported by server 2008 R2, we can it can support 64 GB RAM only. But we talk about server 2012 R2, the RAM can be supported up to 1 TB per virtual machine. So this is also one of the biggest feature added and biggest difference between the server 2008 R2 and server 2012 R2. And let's talk about some more features or some more differences between server 2008 and server 2012 in next slide. If we talk about virtual processor per virtual machine, so in server 2008 R2 it can support up to 4 processors, but in case of server 2012 R2 it can support up to 64 processors. It is a very very strong and very very useful feature as compared to server 2008 R2. And let's talk about some more feature. And now in this slide, if we talk about virtual machine activate, if we talk about server 2008, it can activate up to 384 virtual machines, and in server 2012 it can support up to 1024 virtual machines. So this is also one of the greatest feature added in server 2012 as compared to server 2008 R2. And let's talk about next. There are some other features available with server 2012 which are not available with server 2012. So in next slide I will be talking about one by one all the features and what are the comparisons and what are the differences between all those features in term of server 2008 or server 2012. So let's begin with the very first one, private LAN. What is private LAN, whether and what is the use of private VLAN actually? So as you can see here, I have mentioned very clearly whether it is supported by server 2008 or not. So as you can see, private VLAN is not supported by server 2008, and you can see there are some more features not supported by server 2008. So I have mentioned clearly no 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 no. And this side, if we talk about server 2012, all roles are supported by the server 2012. So I will be talking about one by one all the roles or all the features here. So let's begin with the very first one, private VLAN. What is private VLAN here? So the private VLAN is stand for private virtual LAN or private virtual local area network. So I have taken a very small description here. What is private LAN? If we talk about private VLAN, it is also known as port isolation. It is also known as a port isolation, or in another word, we talk about private VLAN. It is a technique in computer networking where a VLAN contains switch ports that are restricted such that they can only communicate with a given uplink. The restricted ports are called private ports. So as you can see here, there is a switch in this image, and there is a uplink, and we have two server here, and they are connected through this isolated ports. So private VLAN is not supported with server 2008, but if we talk about server 2012, it is available with server 2012, and it is one of the very very strong feature added with server 2012. And now let's talk about the next feature which is available with server 2012 and not available with server 2008, DHCP guard. This is also one of the greatest feature added with Server 2012. What is DHCP guard here? So if we talk about what is DHCP guard, DHCP guard is a new property in Server 2012 Hyper-V that you can configure for each network adapter in a virtual machine. When DHCP guard is enabled, it presents a VM. VM means virtual machine from acting as a DHCP server. So if you want to enable your DHCP guard, you can enable it, but if your requirement is to enable it, you can enable it. So the biggest advantage of enabling this DHCP guard is when DHCP guard is enabled, it prevents a virtual machine from acting as a DHCP server. If you have enabled your this feature DHCP guard in your server, so it will not allow this virtual machine to act as a DHCP server. And this feature is very important. You can see and you can secure your DHCP a server or whatever you want best possible. So this feature is not available with Server 2008, and it is available with Server 2012. So let's now talk about router guard. What is router guard? Router guard is another advanced networking feature that was added in Server 2012. When you enable router guard hyper, vSwitch will discard the following packets. If we talk about router guard, if you will enable this router guard in your network, it will discard the following packets: ICMP version 4 type 5 redirect message, or it will discard ICMP version 4 type 9 router advertisements. So this is the basic functionality of router guard, or the main function of router guard, which and this feature is not available with Server 2008, and it is available with Server 2012 only. This is also one of the greatest feature added with Server 2012. So now let's move to next feature. What is the difference between Server 2008 and Server 2012? And it is called Hyper-V extensible switch. What is Hyper-V extensible switch here? See, Windows Server 2012 introduces this Hyper-V extensible switch, also called Hyper-V virtual switch, which is a virtual Ethernet switch that runs in the management operating system of the Hyper-V parent partition. So this is also one of the greatest feature added with Server 2012 and not available with Server 2008. And let's move to next feature. So the next feature is generic routing encapsulation. In short, it is GRE, generic routing encapsulation. So let's talk about what is generic routing encapsulation. Generic routing encapsulation is a protocol that encapsulate packets in order to route other protocols over IP network. So the basic function is to encapsulate packets in order to route other protocols over IP network. And GRE was developed as a tunneling port tool meant to carry any OSI layer 3 protocol over an IP network. In essence, GRE create a private point-to-point connection like that of a virtual private network, which is also known as VPN. So this feature is also not available with Server 2012, but if we talk, it is available with Server 2012 and not available with Server 2008. And let's move to next feature. So the next feature is non-uniform memory access. Let's talk about what is non-uniform memory access here. So non-uniform memory access is a method of configuring a cluster of microprocessor in multiprocessing system so that they can share memory locally, improving performance and the ability of the system to be extended. NUMA, in short, it is NUMA, is used in a symmetric multiprocessing, which is also known as SMP system. As you can see here, we have two disks available here, and you can see memory is here and memory is also here. So it is connected through a shared bus, which is you can see here non-uniform memory access, and we have multiple CPUs available here. So the basic function is to this method is available to configure a cluster of microprocessor in a multiprocessing system so that they can share memory locally. If our cluster or cluster disk or server wants to share their local memory with the help of this feature, they can share. And let's go further. What is the next difference, or what is the function of non-uniform memory access? Under non-uniform memory access, a processor can access its own local memory faster than non-local memory. So this is one of the greatest feature or greatest benefit or advantage of this feature added with Server 2012, which is not available with Server 2008. And let's next move to our another feature. The next feature or difference between Server 2008 and Server 2012 is Hyper-V Smart Paging. Hyper-V Smart Paging is a process which allows a virtual machine to temporarily use hard disk space to supplement storage of non-volatile memory. So the main function of Hyper-V Smart Paging is to allow a virtual machine to temporarily use hard disk space to supplement storage of non-volatile memories. And one of the next important thing about this feature is smart paging is only used during VM means virtual machine restarts when there is no available physical memory. If physical memory is not available and your virtual machine is going to be restarted or restart, only this time this smart paging will be used. And I talk about the next thing regarding Hyper-V Smart Paging is virtual machines often require more memory during startup. So virtual memory doesn't require a very huge memory at the time of startup. So this was one of the greatest or very helpful or very useful feature available with Server 2012 and which is not available with Server 2008. And let's move to next feature comparison between Server 2008 and Server 2012. So the next one is resource metering. So let's we spend some time talking about what is resource metering here and what is the use or what are the advantages here. So Hyper-V in Windows Server 2012 introduces resource metering. It is a feature that allow customer to create cost effective usage based billing solutions. With this feature, service provider can choose the best billing strategy for their business model. So this is also one of the useful feature available with Server 2012, and which allows customer to create cost-effective usage-based billing solutions. So now, going further and talking about this feature is it also allows organizations to avoid the expenses and complexity associated with bundling in-house metering solutions to track usage within a specific business unit. It also enables hosting providers to quickly and cost-effectively create more advanced, reliable, usage-based billing solution that adjusts to the provider's business model and strategy. So it is very, very helpful for the organization, for the resource management or metering, and very, very good to have the knowledge about this feature. And this is also not available with Server 2008, and it is available with Server 2012 only. So this is one of the biggest feature, and in term of comparison between Server 2008 and Server 2012. And let's move to next one. The next one is offloaded data transfer, which is also known as ODX. So let's talk about what is the use of ODX or offloaded data transfer, and how it is different with Server 2012 and Server 2008, or whether it is available with Server 2008 or 2012. So offloaded data transfer is a feature in Microsoft Windows Server 2012 that speeds up copy and move operations. As you can see in this image, it is very helpful for the move of the data or copying of the data from one place to another place, or some movement of the operation activities from one server to another server, or one disk to another disk. As you can see in this graphic, we have one disk this side, and we have one disk this side, virtual disk, and the data which is this side is read data only, and this side write data. Now this data is moving from read to write data, so it is happening, or it is happening because of this feature, or we can manage, or we can conduct such activity if required in our organization or infrastructure. So the standard copy operations are achieved by reading the data onto the server, buffering it and writing it to another storage volume. So this is also one of the greatest feature and available with Server 2012, which is not available with Server 2008. And let's go to next slide, which is cluster shared volume, CSV 2.0. So this is also one of the very, very useful, very, very important feature available with Server 2012, which is not there with Server 2008. But let's talk about this cluster shared volume 2.0. So cluster shared volume CSV is feature of failover clustering, first introduced in Server 2008 R2. If we talk about this, so it was not available with Server 2008, but Microsoft introduced this feature with Server 2008 R2 for use with Hyper-V role. It came with the Hyper-V role, and it is very, very useful in the case of a failover clustering. Failover clustering is very, very a helpful and very important concept in term of server terminology or for the organization. So let's move to next sentence. A cluster shared volume is a shared disk containing an NTFS volume that is made accessible for read and write operation by all nodes within Windows Server failover cluster. So it is available with the volume or hard disk or server, whatever we have, the that file system of that OS or that hard disk should be NTFS, or it was came with this kind of configuration or hardware requirement. So this was introduced with Server 2008 R2, but here I'm talking about cluster shared volumes CSV 2.0. so this 2.0 is not available with Server 2008 or Server 2008 R2, but it is available with Server 2012 only. And as you can see here, as mentioned, this feature of failover clustering first introduced in Server 2008 R2 for use with the Hyper-V role. A cluster shared volume is a shared. You should pay a little bit attention here. Cluster shared volume is a shared disk containing an NTFS volume. NTFS volume it should be in term of Server 2008 R2, but if we talk about Windows Server 2012 R2, it should be REFS file. REFS file is available with Server 2012 R2 only, and the version of this cluster shared volume is 2.0, which is not there with Server 2008 R2. It was one of the greatest difference between Server 2008 R2 and Server 2012 R2. Let's move to next feature which is available with Server 2008 and Server 2008. If we talk about application monitoring is it is a very basic requirement of any organization to use multiple applications to fulfill the requirement of the users or fulfill the requirement to perform their tasks. So we need to run multiple applications according to the requirement of the business. So application monitoring is also very essential for the administrator or your technology team, and so that you can manage your applications by time properly. So if we talk about these features in Server 2008 R2, it was not available, but there was a feature which is known as performance monitor. We can monitor the performance of the hardware or your server only, but we were not able to monitor applications performance or application, what is the status of applications. So but if we talk about Server 2012 R2, it is there. This Server 2012 R2 came with application as well as performance monitor. So both the features are available with Server 2012 R2, but this application monitoring is not available with Server 2008 R2. And in a similar way, there is one more feature added to Server 2012 is virtual hard disk format. Virtual hard disk format feature is not there with Server 2008 R2. If we want to format our virtual disk in Server 2008 R2, so we cannot format it. But if we talk about Server 2012 R2, we can format your virtual hard disk also. So in this video I prepared this much of only for you people or you guys. I hope this was very informative for you people, and you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have learned the basic differences between Server 2008 R2 and Server 2012 R2, and this will be very useful for you people if you go through this video, and will be helpful to know what are the differences. And I will be preparing some more videos in my next video regarding the configuration of Server 2012, installation of Server 2012, and I will be preparing in similar way, differentiating between both the servers. So for today it was up to this only, and please like this video and subscribe this video, and thanks for watching this video.